Okay, hello everyone, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Here we are at what looks to be pretty much the top of the Grand Archives. And I don't know if this is where we need to go, but it pretty much looks like it. They're giving you this for a reason. I'm gonna do it because, yeah. I mean, if it's here, again, it's here for a reason, and I don't wanna... Well, thank you for that. What do we have? Undead Bone Shard, nice. That's gonna give us plus 9 Estus flasks. I wonder how far up you can go with the Estus. I guess plus 10 would make sense. Make the most sense. Okay, we're out on the roof again. I'm kind of lost now. Well, not even lost. I wouldn't say lost, but... lost on which path I should take. What is the point of this? Am I missing something here? Wait a second. Now you. It's not for breaking one of these windows. That is weird. I don't get it. Unless, you know what? I think I get it. If you take like some other path, maybe you go down and drop from there. So yeah, this might be the other end of something. But I guess I pretty much exhausted the possibilities here on where to go. Oh, wait. You definitely want to do that. That's going to be a shortcut. Something I probably will need. Okay, what do we have here? I don't like the look of that. What is that? Looks like a statue, but... we're not taking any risks here. Okay. Looked like something you could break, but I guess not. I am liking this area a lot. It's like, it's good that it's still part of Lothric Castle, but it still stands out as its own separate area. It's kind of something I like. What the hell is... because this statue looks different. That's for sure. Is it supposed to like represent Osiris or something? Oops. Not what I meant to do. Huh. Well, whatever. I guess it's there for decoration only. Get a nice view of the whole area. I think that is the Consumed King's Garden. No, actually, maybe not. But something is def... oh, shit. 3 NPCs. Okay. Fuck that noise for now. We're gonna go ahead and head back to our bonfire here. I thought about homewarding for a second, but that's just gonna... it's gonna be a waste of a homeward bone. Yeah, we're not gonna... not gonna fight 3 NPCs with this much health. Not even this much health, this many Estus flasks. Because one NPC is you... God, this is still a long run back, isn't it? There is no other ladder that I missed, is there? I'm just trying to think of the shortest way I would be able to get back here. It doesn't really see... oh, maybe... well, you... coming back, you could do this. Like, drop down. It's not gonna help going up, though. Wait, what the hell? Now, I've fought this guy before, haven't I? Alright, whatever. Just finish him off. Hopefully, this isn't gonna be the one that kills me. He is gonna be the one that kills me. Damn, I had 50,000 souls. Well, I guess we're going back to the bonfire either way. Just, am I gonna be able to find this again? I should really cut this. You know what? I'll find my souls... and I'll edit out me going back up to the top, because that's gonna take a lot of time. Again, I don't know if I missed another ladder that I haven't kicked down yet. Alright, so we need to find our souls, which is probably gonna be a more difficult task than I expect. Because no, it's not here. In fact, it's probably all the way up. I'm kind of confused with the layout of this area. You probably need more than one run through here to really get it, because this isn't where the knight is. No, actually it might be. If I run up here, is that gonna... No, it's not. The knight is still above us, isn't he? Or maybe this is? No, this is it. Okay, cool. And backstabbed. Can I knock him down so that he won't bother me? Nah, almost can, but... Okay, I really should... That lock-on... Should heal. No, I don't even think about... Yeah, these ones with the great shield are incredibly annoying. Wow, that deals a lot of damage. Especially since I can't kick away the shield with one kick. Fuck you, get backstabbed again. I know it's lame backstabbing this much. Did he drop something? Yeah, large shard. Okay, you know what? Maybe I won't edit this out because I need to figure out sort of the most efficient way to get up there. This isn't it. Otherwise, it's gonna be kind of annoying. Because I kind of anticipate that I'm going to die a lot to those NPCs. NPC fights are usually pretty challenging. Especially if it's 3-on-1. Not as bad as Bloodborne, though. I don't know. Oh, hello there. I feel like Bloodborne, they really went overboard with the NPC hunters. To the point of making them OP. No, this is not the right way. Actually, what I probably... we should run up this way. Okay, so I have to run up this way. I still don't know what the treasure is. Honestly, I'm not gonna get it now. And then we have to run all the way across. Luckily, these sorceries have terrible tracking, so we don't need to worry about too much. And then drop down, which is probably not a good idea, because I take fall damage. And then, where is the ladder? Wait a second. It's still not here. And then we need to go up. Yeah, and this is gonna get us back to where the ladder is. Okay, holy shit. This is gonna be kind of irritating. Like, fuck, he went for that spell. Please don't hit me with that. That actually has... That still looks like a spell that sucks. What was it called in Dark Souls 2? It's like Soul Shower or something. I don't know. The only thing I remember about it is that it sucked. And from what I've seen, I don't think my opinion's changed yet. I have to take these guys on one by one. There is no way. Oh, you have a bow as well. You have a katana. Oh shit, are you... There's no way to... Oh, they have Estus too. They don't have that much HP, actually. Especially this first one. Someone has sorceries. Okay, so sorcerer... One down, cool. Are these the... Okay, Goldwing Crest. I want to pick them up because I don't want to accident... Whoa, what the hell is that? Is that some sort of... It must be like a unique katana, isn't it? Fuck you and your healing. It doesn't heal a lot. Thank you, Hyper Armor. Yeah, I knew I would need a lot of Estus for this fight. Onikiri and whatever. I couldn't read it. Come on, you pussy. Yeah, you have no poise, do you? Okay, they don't have... Again, they don't have a lot of HP. So... That wasn't as difficult as I thought, but I did need a lot of Estus. Sage's Crystal Staff. Okay, let's recap what we got. So we got a shield. Golden Wing Crest Shield. This is the magic one, finally. A blue knight's shield engraved with a golden crest. This shield is exceptional among the enchanted blue shields. Not only does it boast high magic absorption, but also enables its wielder to parry spells. How does it look? Yeah, it looks good. It looks good. We also got a katana. Onikiri and Ubadachi. The hunter is known as the King's Black Hands. So these were the King's Black Hands, or at least that one was. And we also had Gotthard. But Gotthard is the one who fled the castle, and that's why you can summon him. Interesting. These belong to Kamui, who looked after the prince. Kamui brought Onikiri with him to the undead settlement, where he forged Ubadachi and was finally prepared to join the ranks of the royal hunters. Oni Slayer leaped forward and slashed mercilessly with both blades, cutting foes open. That's what he did to me. Interesting. So we had Gotthard, Kamui, and I guess someone else, a third one. And we also got the Sage's Crystal Staff. Crystal Catalyst presented as a gift by the Crystal Sages to their favorite pupil, Krimhild, I guess. Crystal spheres devour the will of the user, and this staff increases the potency of sorceries at the cost of increased FP consumption for skills. Interesting, it is kind of like Logan's Catalyst. If you didn't know, there was an item, Logan's Catalyst, in Dark Souls 1, which... made your spells stronger, but I think it halved the amount of uses you had. I think so. So if you had 20 uses on Soul Arrow, you'd instead have 10. This has got to lead back. This has got to be a shortcut. I actually don't mind that I went back to the bonfire because I technically died, but you know. It was good in the end. And where does... Oh, this leads back to the very first bonfire. And I have 92,000 souls. So we're definitely gonna visit Firelink Shrine. This area is really cool. I really liked it. Again, these NPCs, they kind of... I guess they learned from Bloodborne that... Maybe you should balance these guys a little bit, because Bloodborne NPC fights were ridiculous, to the point that I hated them. And yeah, you should never hate. Oh, the shield, the spell parry is really cool. Yeah, it's a really nice effect. There's that improved graphics. PS4, of course. I'm just gonna level up. Two levels. Let's see. Why not? I'm gonna get each of these to 30, I think. And that should basically make me strong enough for the rest of the game, I think. I'm gonna Ember up as well, because... why not? And we also have an undead bone shard to burn. And we gotta head back, because this area is getting interesting. Well, I think we're gonna be moving past this area now. I still don't know what was up with that first elevator I encountered, you know, next to the Dragon Slayer armor. It just said contraption does not move. So maybe it's something you need a key for or something? I don't know. But whatever, we're gonna go ahead and head up and see what's beyond here. I feel like we're gonna be moving into more of Lothric, maybe. Because this Grand Archives place looks like pretty much a separate area. And maybe we're gonna cross that bridge I saw earlier and head into kind of the highest part of Lothric. That's probably where the prince is gonna be. So if I had to make a guess, yeah, this is definitely where we're heading. We're either, the boss is either gonna be the prince himself, or it's gonna be like his guard or something. It's probably gonna be super difficult, although Dragon Slayer armor wasn't so bad. That looks so cool. Eclipse, that looks like a dark sign. Really love the design on this game. It's so like engrossing. And same with Bloodborne as well. It was just like sucked you into its world. Okay, this is interesting. Oh, we can go up. Let's see what's this gonna lead to. These pilgrim butterflies, I still don't know what these things are doing. I have a feeling they're gonna be shooting up the bridge with spells as I try to cross it. So these are all different entrances into... Huh. There is something, you can like look out. I wanna get a view of this place. Oh no, actually that doesn't link together. Huh. So this leads up here, all of these. Oh, hello. These ones actually have... Oh, these ones are stronger. This fucking spin to win. I don't think I can backstab these things, can I? Oh, that poise. The other ones didn't have, like, wings, did they? Just, like, little useless wings. No, poise! I don't know what that was. And I'm glad I didn't get hit by it. Looked like a spell. Oh, there's two of them? Alright, fatso. Doesn't actually deal that much damage. That probably does. God damn, that spin... Oh, there's so many of them. An axe... Oh, shit. No, don't even think about killing me. I just turn back into embered form. I don't like that I'm getting attacked by two of these things. Also don't like that they can't be backstabbed. Accidental kick. That's quite odd. I forgot that he goes into the spin. These guys are taking the philosophy of spin to win to heart. Another large shard. Interesting. Want to see what's up this place though. I want to get to the top of the world basically. And looks like this is gonna be it. And we'll see if we can dive into a haystack from up here or not. Yeah, I'm pretty much on top of the world. Hunter's Ring. This is kind of awesome. Well, that tower is actually taller, but still. It's still only 17 minutes in. Good. I'm liking this. Suddenly feels like I'm on top of the world. These pilgrim butterflies. Still don't know where they're going or what these... Again, I've said that more than once. Really cool. I love places like this. Getting high up. Alright, we're gonna also have to pick up that treasure. And take care of this guy. If this one kills me, I'm gonna be angry because made it through your two friends. You don't have spin to win though, so. It's cool that. Oh, there it is. Oh, shit. It's like. What was that Heavenly Thunder it was called? Oh, you can backstab them. Okay. That was like Heavenly Thunder, except maybe sorcery. Wow, that should have staggered you at least. Thank you, Hyper Armor, Titanite Slab, whoa. You know what this means? I could technically max out my... What you call it? Fume Ultra. Estus Shard, nice. And we also got the Hunter's Ring. Maybe this one actually does something useful, but I think it's gonna be increasing our dex, maybe? If I can find it. I picked it up, didn't I? What the hell? Oh, there it is. Okay. Increases dexterity, yeah. The hunters serve Lothric on the fringes and in the shadows. For generations, rulers of Lothric have relied especially upon the Black Hand hunters to punish enemies in ways that the king's three pillars cannot. So basically like assassins, right? That is essentially the vibe I'm getting from these guys. Still kind of cool. And we have this area, which is a drop down that I don't really like. Oh, okay. We're back at the Grand Archives, right? And there is a cage. Getting shot with spells, whatever. And this is Divine Pillars of Light. That can't get... There are feathers here. Huh. And a corpse. That's the spell they were using. So is it a sorcery or a miracle? It's a miracle. 30. Miracle of Gertrude, the Heavenly Daughter, brings down multiple pillars of light. The Queen's Holy Maiden Gertrude was visited by an angel who revealed this tale to her. Despite losing both her sight and her voice, she was determined to record the tale. Ordinary man cannot decipher her fragmentary scroll, nor comprehend how it became the foundation of the angelic faith of Lothric. Finally, we're getting some explanations. So, Gertrude... But didn't the other one say that Gertrude was the daughter of... The Heavenly Daughter was imprisoned in the lofty cell of the Grand Ark. So this is Gertrude, or at least what's left of her. Not much. And she designed this miracle, or she was visited by an angel. She wrote down the miracle. It became the foundation of the church, or the religion worshipping angels. And that's where these weird knights come from. And blessed gem, useless. And they were exiled because they didn't conform to the three pillars of Lothric. Oh, hey there. Oh, there's more places to go from here. It's one of those weird worm things. Oh, you know what? No? Yeah, of course. I rule. Fuck you and your spells. I'm gonna lock off because... Where the hell does this lead? Wait a second. I haven't been here, have I? No, I haven't. These are mimics? Not a mimic. Cool. We have Divine Blessing. And Twinkling Titanite. So interesting, so... Yeah, I get it. I kind of get the lore here. This leads back to... Let's see. Where are we? Kind of lost again. Oh, this is where it leads. Okay, I'm still gonna Homeward Bone back. Yeah, so... Okay, so Guinevere's daughter, Gertrude, was visited by an angel. She became the foundation of a religion. She was imprisoned in that cell... And that's where the miracle comes from. And these weird fat knights with the wings worship her. And that was basically a no-no in Lothric. The only thing is, why would, if she really is the daughter of Gwendolyn... Am I saying Gwendolyn? Yeah, scratch. Whenever I said Gwendolyn, scratch that. It's Guinevere. So why would Guinevere allow her daughter to be imprisoned if she was the... But then, because it's almost like the kind of like there was a change in the royal family because Osiris is kind of exiled as well. I don't know. Just speculating. The lore of this game does seem really interesting. What is that shadow over there? Oh, that's just like a shadow. I don't like the look of this, especially with all these pilgrim butterflies around. Hollows at the top here. Essentially, yeah. Oh, I have an Estus shard too that I haven't turned in. I'm just hoping that there is a bonfire up here. I'm only 24 minutes in. We can go on for a little bit more. Oh, wow. This is very Boletaria-like, isn't it? With this bridge and the hollows and things. But I like that they're making kind of references, wow, there's a lot of them, to Demon Souls, or throwbacks to Demon Souls as well, because that's something the previous games haven't really done. Not especially this overtly, and we have a Black Eye Knight. This is just like straight up a Demon Souls sequence, and these... Oh, there you go. Yeah, just come out. This is gonna be stronger than the other ones. Nah, actually, no. The ones with the red cape and the red Lothric stuff. Wow. I don't know if I just got lucky or if that guy is guaranteed to drop that. I don't know why I got hit by that. These fucking assholes with the spears, I hate them. Alright, no. Don't even think about healing. Oh wow, they can take you out very quickly. Holy shit. This is like the most dangerous enemy here. What if I kick? Oh, you can kick these guys away. That makes things a lot easier. What else do we have up ahead? The one with the spear. Well, it's something that we're gonna have to tackle in the next episode. How cool is this though? This shot of the castle and the kind of sun. It's really awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this episode here because I've been going for a while. I'm gonna go ahead and thank you guys very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode of Dark Souls 3. I feel like we're making good progress. We'll see what's up ahead. Hopefully a bonfire. Thanks for watching, and I'll see all of you next time. Goodbye.